MVP events. Can they be beaten? We will find out. Third member of our broadcast team down on the sand, Mike Dodd with Misty May. Mike.
Thank you, Chris. Misty, so much pressure every time you play. How do you keep it so fun?
I think, you know, we try new things when we get out there. Obviously, we need to work on our hand setting because we don't try that as much. But, you know, each time we face a different team, especially, you know, when it's not EY and Rachel, you don't know what to expect. They're always gunning for us. So we try to keep, you know, our intensity on our side and just have fun. You know, the crowd, we love getting involved with the crowd, and we love, they give us energy.
What do you expect from Jenny and Annette today?
They have nothing to lose. Last tournament of the year, they're going to, I think, serve us very tough. I was watching their game earlier. They're playing very good team defense. So we've got to just control the ball on our side. And when we have opportunities to put the ball away, we have to convert.
Very good. Let's go over to Dwight Stones with Jenny Johnson Jordan.
All right, Mike, Triple J, you guys have met these people before. 20-3 lifetime. You had a tough semifinal today. What do you have to do to push this team?
For us, we have to be aggressive. I have to hit the ball.
In this kind of a situation, they're so dominant, 14 events. Do you just go for it, everything, caution to the wind?
You just have to go for it. You don't want to look back and regret not going for it. And like I said, they're a strong team, so we have to go for it. We have to play strong, serve tough, and go out there and try to beat them.
All right, good luck with that. Chris Marlowe?
All right, a daunting task for Annette Davis and Jenny Jordan. Time to Nautica navigate the match with Karch Karai. Let's start with Misty and Carrie. What do they have to do today?
Well, Misty May already talked about it. She knows the serves are going to be coming hard, and they have to control those when they come over the net. The one weakness they've shown so far this year is controlling that serve. Of course, they also have to fuel their fire. Sometimes it's hard to keep your focus when so many good things happen so easily to them. They make it look easy, but they got to keep their focus. For Jordan and Davis, of course, they're going to have to launch those heat seekers. Jenny talked about it with Dwight, and that is serve rockets down there to put pressure. That's the one best way to put pressure on Mae Walsh. And Jenny Johnson Jordan Triple J needs to be steady. At times, she has been very focused and very tough to stop offensively. Other times, a little more inconsistent.
Annette Davis and Jenny Jordan. There's Davis, 5'11". She's 32 years old, lives in Valencia, California, 2000 Olympian. She was a 1994 Pac-10 Player of the Year indoors at UCLA. She is outstanding. Her partner, Jenny Jordan, born in Sherman Oaks, California, now living in Tarzana. Jenny with 8 career wins. Jordan and Davis, 5th in the Olympic Games in 2000. And recently have had kids in the last 5-6 years, taking 2 years off to have babies. And, of course, on the other side is the great Carrie Walsh, who's 28 years old. She's 62. She has won 62 tournaments. That's 4th on the all-time list. And her partner is the great one, Misty May, who is now 29 years old. She can tie a milestone today. She has 66 open wins. She can tie the great Carolyn Kirby for 2nd on the all-time wins list. So Mae Walsh, a heavy favorite team. And, of course, Davis and Jordan trying to buck the trend. Today's AVP Cincinnati Open is brought to you by Sony Bravia LCD TV, official HD TV of the AVP Pro Beach Volleyball Tour. We are set, ready to go. As Dwight Stones alluded to, this will be the 25th meeting all time between these two teams. Mae and Walsh have won 20 of those matches.
Every slide.
And punching it through is Annette Davis. If you're Davis and Jordan, Karch, who do you serve of Mae and Walsh?
Well, in the semifinal, there were some tough serving from the team that Mae and Walsh faced, much of it going short to Walsh with a little bit of success. So I think they should start trying to move Walsh up, take her, or push her deep like this serve.
Walsh hits it, and it bounces on the tape and the line.
Mostly you have to move Walsh short or deep to try to take her out of her comfort zone. And those short serves can make it a little harder for her to get a good run up to the net and a good jump.
Now Carrie Walsh with the serve. And Walsh has got it. Davis with the rip. She's got it on the line. So Annette Davis, who was a gifted outside hitter at UCLA, as was Jenny Jordan.
And certainly not just a gifted indoor player, but a great beach player. In fact, winning the individual championship 2 years ago in Hawaii, the goddess of the beach, so to speak, where you alternate partners, and she was the queen that time.
Davis with the serve. Early action 2-1. Nice dig. Davis on the move. Misty May digs back. Davis looking for the put away. And she's got it.
Well, some great defense so far by both players. Let's watch and listen to the communication. You can hear Walsh saying, line though. Listen to the call again from Jordan.
Line reach! Go, go, go! Nice!
The line reach call, that was open. The nice short shot, drop shot down the line. Walsh unable to track it down.
Jordan and Davis off to a 3-1 start. And the serve into the net.
That's the one you say you can train to master, right? The dribbler over the net, Chris Marlowe?
I think you can. I think you can possibly do it. We saw Phil Dalhouser yesterday hit a couple of those. And I think if you hit the ball hard enough with low trajectory, and you could work on that. I'm not saying you can perfect it. I think you can work on it. Over the top and down. And obviously you disagree. I don't think you can possibly work on that.
Oh, yeah, you can work on it. I don't know if you're going to have a lot of success with it, but you can practice it.
Well, with your pathetic little serve, you would not have the concept to really do something like that. But I'm talking about the big servers on tour.
The lollipop serve.
That's there you go.
I mastered the lollipop.
Misty May has mastered the spike attack. Misty May cracks one through. And we're off to a good start here in Cincinnati.
A little bit of a mistake here, dropping off the net. You do not want to leave an open net for Misty May. She's going to do some damage.
Game one. Annette Davis and Jenny Jordan off to a good start, leading 4-3. Always worth it. We are back in Mason, Ohio, in the midst of game one. And surprisingly, Johnson and Jordan have a one-point lead over the gold medalists. Hi again, everybody, and welcome Chris Marlowe and Karch Karai. Of course, the big story on the beach always, Misty May and Kerry Walsh. They won 14 of 16 AVP events, the dominant team. What makes them so good?
Well, they're not just good, Chris. They're the best team of all time, 60 wins together. What makes them so good is they're both the total package. Misty May is unbelievable on defense. You can see her just digging the ball up. It really starts with Kerry Walsh at the net, but everything that gets past her, Misty May vacuums up, and she can put it down with the finesse shots or with the hammer like she brings out here. We saw her earlier in this game breaking out the heat. And Kerry Walsh, one of the things she loves to do best is drop off the net from the blocking position, dig the ball up and put it down like that. Here, another dig, very unusual for a 6'3" player. Now, we're at the season-ending event. Have they made a case for themselves for MVP? I say they've both made a case for themselves. Gotta go. The stats are so close in all the categories that you've gotta go with the double MVP, and that's really what you're facing, a check mark to each one. Both players, it's like you're playing against two MVPs every weekend, and that's why it's so tough to beat them.
In 2004, Misty May and Kerry Walsh had won 15 straight tournaments and 89 straight matches. Then Jenny Jordan and Annette Davis ended that streak at Manhattan. This is one team that has confidence in beating Walsh and May.
But this is the only team still existing on the AVP that has actually beaten May and Walsh. They've done it three times, but never in a final. Maybe today if they steady it out.
A one-point lead for Jenny Jordan and Annette Davis as we play here in game one. Weather's good. A little bit overcast, warmer than yesterday. Not much breeze, ideal for the players. And Jordan is blocked by Misty May.
That's a difficult play for Jordan. The ball went a little too close to the net. Now, Misty May is not as big a blocker as Kerry Walsh, but she has great technique. And whenever there's a ball that's close to her hand, she's going to be on top of it like she was there.
4-4, game one.
Line over.
Jordan rips one, yes.
If you notice, that was a much better set. That was about 3 feet off the net, and it's much more difficult for the blocker to actually get her hands on the ball. Easy put away for Jordan as a result.
Davis with the serve, going after Misty May. And Misty puts it away. Just a moment ago, Dane Selznick talking in the huddle to his crew about setting. Listen.
I'll tell you, that set is almost from 3 to 4 feet off the net. They're dropping off. So let's really see that and know that we can bomb them on their way back. Let's don't give them any soft stuff. Let's really be aggressive on this court here. This is a great court to hit from off the net, and we can do it well. So let's keep thinking that way and get that last second call saying no one up there.
Dane Selznick, the longtime coach for Misty May and Kerry Walsh. Of course, passing and setting so important in beach volleyball.
And he was referring also to the hard pack out here with the rain of the last 2 days. The court hasn't had enough time to dry yet. It's so hard packed that all four players are jumping higher than they would on a normal coastline beach.
Can anybody jump out there, Karch?
Yes, even you, Chris.
Come on, right behind.
Misty with a bad pass. Pretty good set and the put away. Let's go down to Mike Dodd for more on the sand.
Well, Chris, down here on the sand, Karch and everyone else is right. It's hard packed, and Dane makes a good point. You want to keep your sets well off the net because with the sand so hard, you jump so much higher, you have so much more range that it's easy to put it away.
Kerry Walsh with the serve. 6-6 tie. Oh, Jordan. Got a hit against Misty, I think. And that one's too high. So May and Walsh have the lead at 7-6.
And we talked about it before. That's the one trouble that Jordan can have is keeping the ball in the court. In fact, in the semifinal, she had a chance to put the match away at 14-13, hit it out a few inches. She's got to steady it out and keep those balls inside the court, put the pressure on May Walsh.
Well, Davis with a good set to Jordan. And the teams will switch sides. 7-7, a good game one. AVP on NBC will continue. Stay tuned. The AVP Cincinnati Open presented by Liftoff, the 14th and final regular season event on the AVP Crocs Tour. Next week, a specialty event in Las Vegas, and then the week after, the tour will move to Lake Tahoe as Walsh taps it down.
Probably the strategy that Jordan and Davis are going to want to use, though, is that a really tough serve to Kerry Walsh, try to get a poorer pass. That really wasn't a bad pass. That was a good one. But to move it around on defense, that time, Davis running way over to the line to get it, got her hands on it, but couldn't control it on her side of the net.
Misty May and Kerry Walsh defeating Diane Dinekashe and Holly McPeak in the crossover. Dinekashe and McPeak finished third. And Davis and Jordan. Now, what a play by Misty May. Left hand, up and over. And that one's too good.
And not only the play by May, but how about Walsh coming down from playing so high above the net and then getting laying out. Watch this play. Great line hit by Davis there, but look at that chase by Walsh. That's one of the beautiful things about beach volleyball. You want to try to play so high above the net. Another good touch on this block, but well put away there. So high above the net and so low in the backcourt. Incredible play by both May and Walsh there. One-handed stab, one right-handed, one left-handed.
Davis and Jordan beat Jen Boss and Rachel Walkholder in their crossover. So Boss and Walkholder also finishing third. Misty May blocked by Davis. So Annette Davis, who started her career on the four-person tour. They said Davis and Jordan, yeah, they're good four-person players, but they'll never adjust to two-person. They've done pretty good, making the Olympic team, and Davis a very good blocker.
And they're also great role models for all the other women on the tour, having now had two children. Their typical strategy is qualify for the Olympics, play, have a child, take a year off, come right back strong like they are this year. They've done it twice now.
Davis and Jordan with eight wins games together. They are the longest running team on the AVP Tour, at least in the women's division, maybe in all of beach volleyball. I'm getting a nod. Yes. 9-9 our score. And Davis over the top. A Bud Light summary for Davis and Jordan. They've had some tough matches, but they persevered.
Yes, they did. Well, the one tough one they had was yesterday playing against Mae Walsh and losing. They have nowhere to go but up, as they talked about. Just play loose. They've got to go aggressively. They have nothing to lose. None of the teams really have anything to lose against Mae Walsh. If you do something different, well, for the most part, it doesn't change the result. You still lose, so you've got to be really aggressive against that team.
10-9, Davis and Jordan. Misty. Oh! Dig Davis and the backhand flipper score.
Wow. Annette Davis playing some of the best defense I've seen from her all summer long. Two great digs now. One went over the net earlier, but this one she controls perfectly. The rocket.
Wow.
And Jordan fooling them a little bit by going for the hit there instead of setting her partner, finding the open court.
11-9 our score. Misty dug again. Davis right on top. And she puts it away. So Annette Davis on fire. Traditional volleyball where you dig it up, Karch. You get a set from your partner. And then you whack away.
And with this hard pack, she's a little far off the net, but still puts the ball away down the middle.
A surprise brewing in game one. Davis and Jordan leading the gold medalists 12-9.
Unbelievable.
What if she's for real?
Imagine the possibilities.
Yeah.
Studio 60 on the Sunset Strip premieres Monday, September 18th on NBC.
Back at the Linder Family Tennis Center in Mason, Ohio. The Cincinnati Open presented by Liftoff. Davis and Jordan with a lead on Walsh and Mae. Let's go over to Dane Selznick, the coach for Walsh and Mae. Dane, your team's had so much success. Do you think Misty and Carey came in overconfident to this match?
No, they're not overconfident. I think right now the other team is playing pretty well. We just have to make a couple adjustments. I like the way Misty's playing aggressive, but we have to make that adjustment with a cut shot.
When you faced this team earlier, when they were lost in Birmingham, Alabama, what was it that Mae and Walsh didn't do well enough?
You know, just it was tough to see in Birmingham in the night game. And it was just getting acclimated out there. Jenny and Nettie made all the great plays in transition and kept the ball in play on us, and we kind of beat ourselves out there.
Dane, Misty got dug a bunch in that first stanza. What does she need to do to keep the ball away from Annette Davis?
Well, I just explained to her that she hasn't really used her cut shot yet, and she needs to have a better offensive all-around game. Just to mix it up and keep Nettie, honest, because she's spreading her feet wide and anticipating that hit.
And Dane, one final question from Karch. Every time that the ball has gone to Nettie, or almost every time, she's hit that really nice high line shot. What do you do to adjust to try and slow her down?
Well, we've decided to go the other way. She's pretty comfortable right now doing that, you know, and that's what it comes down to. You know, it's reading when the other team, has somebody that is more at ease at what they're doing, and then you make that change.
All right, Dane, thank you for the insight. We'll check back with you a little bit later. Dane Selznick, coach for Misty Mae and Carey Walsh, in trouble here in game one. Trailing 14-10. Chance for 15. Over the top. Got it. And Jenny Jordan, 33 years old, looking spry, tapping over the top.
Boy, Jordan and Davis are all over the court. Amazing. Now, Misty Mae does a good job of adjusting. Remember, she was getting dug on the hard hit before, so she says, well, I'm going to try a soft shot down the line. But Jordan is all over that, too. Nice adjustment to the other adjustment. It's a real chess game. Again, playing low and playing high. What a great combination of skills you have to be a top beach volleyball player.
A 6-1 scoring run for Davis and Jordan. Misty Mae, Carey Walsh bearing down now, trailing by 5. Easy serve right to Mae. And the cut shot open, as Dane Selznick's suggesting. You don't see a lot of players with really great cut shots, but it's a play that can really help you out.
And one of the very best you'll see watching any man or woman is Misty May. She's got a wonderful cut shot. Holly McPeak is another one. But when you mix that in there, it really keeps the defense honest.
Jordan getting a lot of serves now. Cut shot. Misty's there. Misty read it, and she puts it away. Misty May and Kerry Walsh, one of the great comeback teams in history. Here they come, 15-12.
And they haven't done it just to some teams, but they've even done it to this team, done it a few years ago where they had the match pretty much lost, came back against them in Las Vegas. During this point, May picking up that cut shot so well, getting the good call from Kerry Walsh saying, high line.
Interesting now, Walsh serving and blocking. Misty was blocking earlier, but now that they trail, they go to Walsh at the net. And the big bop by Jordan off the top. So Jordan and Davis with a 16-12 lead. Another side change, and we're coming back. Game one will continue. The gold medalist down by 4. AVP Crocs Tour alive and well in Cincinnati, Ohio. Cincinnati open, and in game one, Johnson and Jordan leading 16-12. Johnson getting the serves down. She is responding, Karch.
Yes, she is. She's keeping her unforced errors down, and that's when she's at her best. Sometimes she gets in a bad groove and just gives easy points to the opponents hitting out, hitting in the net. Doing a great job today of making the other team beat her.
Annette Davis with the serve. Spins one to Misty. Cut shot, Davis is there. Big play here to get to 17. Not yet, Misty digs. Jordan's got it. Taps it, yes! Jenny Jordan, a little knuckle poke. There, a little bit of a collision under the net. And it's 17-12.
But both players, earlier in this rally, Davis started it with another great dig. Both players, Davis and Jordan, not only doing a good job of playing defense and keeping the ball in play, but also finding the open spot on the court. You have to close out your point scoring opportunities almost every time if you want to beat a man Walsh.
Davis again, right in the middle. Bad pass. And another chance here. Jordan, oh, she taped it. Misty's got it. Jordan with a dig, out of bounds. A missed opportunity for Davis and Jordan.
And that missed opportunity is the one they may look back on with regret, because you cannot let May and Walsh have a second chance as they do here. You really have to put the hammer down. This team is so good. 60 wins together. The all-time leading career victory winner is Holly McPeak with 72. As a team, they're close to passing her up.
Misty May with the serve. It's 17-13. Davis and Jordan. Ball's blocked. So Walsh on Jordan gets the block. That's her first block of the day. And sometimes when Walsh gets one, two is right behind.
Well, just a couple of weeks ago, she had a huge blocking match in Coney Island. Getting her hands, watch how she gets her hands across the net there. That's what a blocker wants to do, is reach those arms way across rather than up and high and over the net.
17-14 our score. Back on Jordan. Misty goes and gets it, and the put away. What teamwork.
And May doing a Jordan and Davis on this play, tracking that ball down so well, and all of a sudden it could have been 18-12 if they'd put that point opportunity away. Now 15-17 and coming back, steamrolling back into the game as May and Walsh do so often.
Interestingly, Davis and Jordan do not have a coach. No coach in the coaching box. Dane Selznick, the coach for May and Walsh, in their coaching box. Misty's got another dig. Oh, wow, what a mistake. Ball bumped right over a plum, and Davis squashes it.
And you could see Walsh at the end of that play kind of slapping her stomach saying, wow, all I need to do is put Misty May 3 or 4 feet off the net, and she's probably going to put it down. Lost opportunity the first time for May and Walsh this game.
A very fortunate play for Davis and Jordan, who are trying to hold on here in game one. They lead 18-15. Misty. Jordan's got it. Here comes Misty. Cut shot wide open. Misty May and Kerry Walsh will not give it away.
And again, you don't want to give them two opportunities if possible, but that second time, May is going to put the ball down. Now just, again, 2 points down at 16-18, even with the lost opportunity.
If you're Davis and Jordan, when do you use your timeout? Should they have used one already? Or
I think they already got a service reception point out earlier.
Off the top of Walsh, and Jordan struggling a little bit, trying to get the ball by Walsh.
If they had given up one more point, I would have said definitely a timeout. But now they've got a little bit of their groove back, just 2 points away from winning this first game.
Once again, Davis and Jordan without a coach in the box. Misty May, Kerry Walsh with a coach. Does it make a whole heck of a difference? Well, sometimes it does. Better to have another person in the box if you can. Nice spinner by Jordan. Or Davis, I should say. And May and Walsh with another mistake.
Wow, very strange choice by Kerry Walsh there to try to bump it over the net. That ball's not going to fall on very many good teams. And now it's game point, 20-16.
So four chances for Davis and Jordan to lock up game one. The upset in the making here in Cincinnati. First game point at 20-16.
Misty, cut.
Misty May, and game one is over. Annette Davis and Jenny Jordan take it to Misty May and Kerry Walsh.
Two of the worst plays we may have seen all year for May and Walsh. You remember, Chris, it's a long season. They're on week number 18 in a row, playing on the AVP Tour and overseas when they have a weekend off. It could be wearing on them.
Davis and Jordan win game one. More of the AVP on NBC after this.
Women's Championship Final here at the Cincinnati Open, presented by Liftoff. Game two, Walsh and May have turned things around and lead 9-5. Let's go down to the sand, find out what's happening to Davis and Jordan with Dwight Stones. Dwight.
All right, Chris. It seems like everything you did in game one worked. You were aggressive. You were fast. What's happening now? It seems as though that you've lost a little of the confidence.
We haven't lost confidence. We're just little mistakes here and there. So we just need to clean it up, and we'll be back on track.
What's a major adjustment you now need to make? 4 points down, they're clearly starting to click.
I definitely need to set Jenny better and, just hit it in the court.
Karch was talking about how maybe you weren't approaching as fast, and being a high jumper, I know about good horizontal leads to good vertical. You looked a little tentative on a couple of sets.
I don't know. We'll try to be aggressive now.
Good luck with that. Chris?
All right, Davis and Jordan, magnificent in game one, winning easily 21-16. Just to beat May and Walsh a game is an accomplishment for any beach volleyball team in the world.
It's a chink in the armor, and if you can do it once, you can certainly do it again. But the way to do it is not to give them free points, give them unforced hitting errors. Have to make May and Walsh beat you by playing every ball.
Jordan. And Jordan with her best hit in the last 5 minutes.
And Davis was just talking to Dwight Stones about giving her a better set. That set was really well placed, about 3 feet off the net. And as a result, Jordan got a better swing on the ball, nice extension on her elbow, and hit it down the line.
9-6 our score, off the tape, and it's a point. Karch Karai told you could perfect that if you worked hard enough on it. And there's an example right there.
Oh, Ned, man.
Davis, the tape ace.
When you serve that, you don't know whether to apologize or. In fact, they even have a sound here. They play the Pac-Man sound when it just falls over the net.
If she does it again right now, will you give up and say, Marlo, you're the best, you're the smartest?
Yeah, and it's the best rule ever.
Oh, almost another one.
Angle. Come on.
Nice dig by Annette Davis. And Misty goes and gets it. Oh, what a play by Misty.
What a set by Walsh.
And she rolls it down the line. Yeah, give Kerry Walsh credit. She scooped it up.
She was over the banner, first of all, May, tracking this down, that shot was open, then it wasn't. Look at Walsh reaching over the banner to give a perfect set. Unbelievable. This is a great, May has such a great combination of skills. There are some defensive players who dig the hard hit well, others who dig the shot well. May does both, and then she adds the third dimension. That is, if you get her within 3 or 4 feet of the net, the ball is going down. She terminates.
Misty piling up the numbers. 10-7 our score. Oh, Misty overhand the alligator dig. And she puts that one away. You don't see the gator very often.
Well, I just talked about it, the combination. Last play, she picks up the soft shot. This time, she takes the absolute heat. Let's listen here. Feet of the net, she's going to terminate. That's what makes them so tough. They transition almost every scoring opportunity, and now up by 4 against Jordan Davis.
Davis and Jordan have changed sides, and it works for that play. As Annette Davis taps it down. Annette Davis's father was Cleveland Buckner, an NBA standout who played in the NBA for a number of years and actually played in the Wilt Chamberlain 100-point game. Her dad scored 33.
He was triple his average, right?
33.
And he didn't guard Wilt much of that, so he doesn't get much of the blame for the 100 points.
I asked him about that once. He said, I'm checking the whole game. I didn't give him all that. Jordan pops it through. So just when you thought Davis and Jordan might be going into the tank a little bit, they regain their confidence.
It was probably a good move for them to switch things up and do that unusual play of switching left side and right side. And then another point on transition defense.
11-9 our score. Serving Misty. You know, Misty looks like she's in a groove now. If I'm Davis and Jordan, I'm thinking about serving Carrie a little bit, maybe working her short, working her deep. We'll discuss that option when we come back. Walsh and May on top. We're in Mason, Ohio, 25 miles north of downtown Cincinnati. The AVP Crocs Tour, the final regular season event. A couple of specialty events in the next 2 weeks in Las Vegas and Lake Tahoe. And we have a great match going. You just turned on your television set. The best team in the world, the reigning gold medalist, Misty May and Carrie Walsh, lost game one, 21-16. Really struggled. Davis and Jordan played very well. Davis and Jordan in the final a week ago. Annette Davis, Jenny Jordan, the former UCLA stars. And this is game two. It's 12-10. I'm Chris Marlowe with Karch Karai, Mike Dodd, and Dwight Stone's on hand today. It's a cool day, a little bit warmer than yesterday, however. What's been the story so far, Karch, the overall?
Well, the overall story is that Jordan and Davis played tremendous defense, particularly Davis in game one, and kept their errors down to a minimum, serving really tough. Those are the three keys to beating May and Walsh. This game have a few more errors, and as a result, they're down by 3, but still in it.
Jordan down the line for more on May and Walsh. Let's go down to Mike Dodd. Mike.
Thanks, Chris. You know, Karchi, it always comes down to ball control. In the first game, Misty and Carrie, they weren't passing so well, thus the sets were off a little bit, and Jordan and Davis were able to play great defense. This game, however, the ball control improving, passing improving, the key always to volleyball.
Pass and set. Misty May pops one through. So May and Walsh, who have won 157 matches and lost only 7 since the Olympics, in danger here.
And you can see Davis there, her arms were not across the net, so it makes a perfect target for a hitter. If the hands are straight up and down, arms are straight up and down, all you have to do is hit it off those hands. It falls on the blocker side of the net.
14-11 now. May and Walsh ahead. And Jordan taps it too easy. Walsh is there. Go over. Nice high bump. Carry. Oh, they got it up. Nice. Great play by Jordan. Scoops it over. Misty. Oh, another left-handed dig. Jordan. Rally of the game. Rally of the match. Might be the rally of the tournament.
Oh, too close.
And it's over. Walsh too tall at the net.
Well, Mike Dodd just talked about it. Ball control, they work so hard, and then the easiest part of the play and putting it too close for Walsh. Let's watch this, maybe the rally of the summer. Could hear May calling line, but she hit angle instead. Blocking line.
Jenny Jordan, unbelievable there.
And then here, the easiest part of the play, a pretty easy set by Jordan, but too close. So close, it went over the net. Walsh with the put away. After making some of her best plays of the season, or best plays of the match, Jordan then puts it too close. Unfortunate way to end that rally.
That is a candidate for our Xbox 360 play of the match. I would say
candidate?
A leading candidate right now.
It's a lock.
15-11, game two. Jordan. And Jordan getting aggressive. You know, when you talk to Jordan and Davis, they always talk about, we got to stay aggressive, we got to stay confident. And that really is the key to their game.
It is.
They got to keep powering the ball and popping it.
And you can even watch Davis on this serve. She almost gets up off her leg and into the air. Well, this is a jump serve, but even when she does her float serve, she puts a lot of core into it, and it makes it really tough for the other players to control.
Davis and Jordan won game one. May and Walsh leading here in game two.
Presented by Vonage.
Back here at Cincinnati Beach, the AVP Crocs Tour unfolding at the Lindert Family Tennis Center. And there is the Crocs Cup Trophy, the best team on the beach, men and women, will be engraved on that cup. And Kerry Walsh and Misty May have locked it up. Walsh and May on the men's side, Stein Metzger and Mike Lambert won the cup.
By virtue of making the final yesterday, they locked it up. But May and Walsh have a huge lead over any other team, having made every single Final Four, and in fact, every final on the tour this year.
Annette Davis and Jenny Jordan struggling now here in the late stages of game two. They played very energetically in game one and won. Here in game two, May and Walsh have turned it on. So it looks like we're going to game three at 19-12. Misty May. Little jump floater back on Davis. And that's on the line. If you were May and Walsh, would you be serving Davis at all, or mixing it up like they're doing?
I think I would be keeping it on Jenny, on Jordan, because they really broke it open earlier this game, thanks to some unforced hitting errors by her and tracking down some of her shots.
Jordan with five errors here in game two. She only had two in game one, so a little bit steadier. And now the crowd comes alive as May and Walsh have scored their 20th point. So in a 21-point game, that means game point for May Walsh. Crowd stands here in Cincinnati. Chance to wrap it up for May Walsh. Jordan, this could be it right here. Kerry with the dig. Misty touched it. Had to go over. Davis. Misty's got it. Misty. That will do it. Game two over. The Olympic Beach gold medalist Misty May and Kerry Walsh take charge.
Well, they sure woke up. The sleeping dogs are now wide awake and rabid.
We are tied at one game apiece. Game three coming right up. Stay tuned.
Current weather conditions to get you on your way.
Back at the Linder Family Tennis Center here in Mason, Ohio. The Cincinnati Open presented by Liftoff. Glad you're with us on NBC, our women's championship final. Annette Davis and Jenny Jordan winning game one, a surprise 21-16. But then Misty May and Kerry Walsh turning it on in the late stages of game two to pull away 21-13. We're ready to start game three. Chris Marlowe, Karch Garai, Mike Dodd, and Dwight Stones. Karch, give me a recipe for victory for Davis and Jordan here in game three.
Well, they kept their unforced errors down in game one. They had only three. May and Walsh had four. But the difference in game two, dramatic change. Zero unforced errors for May Walsh in game two. Five for Jordan and Davis. And Jordan and Davis, for any team to have hope to beat the best women's beach volleyball team in history, have to keep the unforced errors down.
Misty May has received 24 serves. Kerry Walsh only five so far. So the plan for Davis and Jordan, try to wear down Misty. Here's Davis, and Davis pops it. You a little bit surprised Misty blocking that time?
Not only surprised that May is blocking, but that they're serving Davis, who has been more effective on offense, less unforced errors than Jordan.
They're giving Jordan perhaps a chance to regroup on offense and get her confidence going.
Well, she played a great game one, just made a few too many errors in game two, and that was the difference.
Now over to Kerry Walsh. Oh, Davis, beautiful dig. And she hammers it down. One of the best plays of the match. And that Davis, wow, digging lips.
And that used to be the only way you could score a point in volleyball. We still call it almost like a serving point or what we call a real point, the players would say, and that is you serve and you play defense. Jordan with the wonderful setup there, keeping the ball away from the net where Walsh can't smother it on the block.
Or maybe a traditional point.
Or a traditional point.
3-1.
Now going for another traditional point.
And it's a score! Davis with the tape ace.
On the player's favorite rule, the let serve rule.
That's the second one in the match. Davis and Jordan lead 4-1. Crowd buzzing here at the Cincinnati Open, presented by Liftoff. Misty May and Kerry Walsh in trouble because of the trickler. A ball that hits the net and carries over. Annette Davis, second trickler of the game. Cards grinding. She looks like she knows what she's doing on it.
She sure does. That rule changed 5 years ago. Before then, that serve was not legal, but that's the one every player dreads, is when it hits the tape and there's nowhere to go but straight down. Can't cover it.
Davis again on Walsh. And Walsh is dug again. Davis looking good. And Misty digs back. Misty May off the top. Oh, wow. Annette Davis with the ball on the net to go to 5.
Remember that point, Chris, the huge opportunity for them to go up 5-1, and May saves the day by playing, doing what she does so well, keeping the ball in play, controlling that hard hit, putting it away.
Misty May, 17 digs. Here comes Jordan. Misty with a dig. That is off, and over the top, Jordan drops it home. So Jenny Johnson Jordan with the tippy. And that makes it 5-2. It's a game to 15, third and final game is to 15. So it's a race as Jordan sets the serve. Misty May cuts it inside. Boy, Davis was on it.
Again, she was unable to get her arms over and across the net, and there was a little space. Let's watch it here. Her arms are going to go straight up a little bit instead of crossing the net. They crossed the net, but it was a little too late. She has to be a little earlier to get that ball and keep it on the other side of the net.
Now, Kerry Walsh sets the serve, trailing 5-3. Jordan, and Kerry goes over and gets it. Davis out of bounds. Jordan's shot just not precise enough. Walsh with a good hustle play.
Well, May and Walsh are really leaning toward that line shot. The best thing to do for Jordan is to crank an angle or hit her own cut shot into that angle open spot on the court.
5-4. Back on Jordan. Jordan jumps. Walsh digs. And Walsh puts it away. So May Walsh, after trailing 4-1, rebound to catch Davis and Jordan at 5.
Remember, they could have been up 5-1, and now here it is tied at 5-all. Again, hands a little apart on the block. Walsh takes advantage. May Walsh right back in it after falling behind early.
May and Walsh have won 5 tournaments in a row. They won 36 out of the last 43 AVP events. Jordan, yes! Is there a good side, bad side, Karch?
No, there really isn't. A good side would be the wind in your face. The bad side would be the wind at your back. And there's very little wind to begin with, and especially it's screened out today by this stadium.
Sun has come out. Virtually no wind. Davis and Jordan leading 6-5. Third and final game, women's championship here in Cincinnati. Annette Davis to serve.
And Jordan on that last hit got a great approach, kept it up high and over the tape.
Davis looking for another trickler, didn't get it that time. Misty. And Misty pops it through. Tough shot.
Misty May with our Vonage spike of the match right there.
And what she did was she hit the seam between the blocker's right arm and the digger's left arm, hitting the middle there very effectively. When she mixes that in and the high line and the cut shot, the digger just can't be there for any, even two of those shots.
Vonage spike of the match, the 20th kill for Misty May. So Misty set to serve, 6-6. Game three, Davis. What a shot by Kerry Walsh. You don't see a bump over kill very often, but there it was.
And she did a really smart thing there. She knew where the hitter was and who the hitter was, and she figures, well, the hitter was at the net. I'm going to try and put her deep before she has time to get back there. That's exactly what happened. If she had bumped that ball cross court instead, Jordan would have had a much easier play on it. But very smart play by Walsh. Even if it doesn't go down, the hitter is really struggling to keep that ball in play.
May and Walsh have their first lead of game three at 7-6. Davis off the, oh, and it drops as Davis gets the kill.
Lucky break for Davis there. Both the blocker Walsh and the digger May were all over that shot, the line shot, but it went off Walsh's left hand and fell down after both had adjusted and were covering the other side of the court.
Davis and Jordan need good play, but they also need a break or two. A couple net plays. And that serve, oh, that was a good one, just wide. So the serve is missed. We'll take a short break. We're coming right back. May Walsh by one. Third and final game here in Cincinnati, 8-7 May Walsh. Just a moment ago, Dane Selznick talking to the gold medalists.
How long can you press at that net to keep that ball from getting by you? We don't want to start anticipating too early at going by us.
And Davis and Jordan have been playing the best match they've played in the Final Four this year, keeping themselves within 1 point in this game three, really hot in game one, playing tremendous defense, especially Annette Davis there with a lot of digs on Misty May. A little bit of a letdown in game two, but they're right in the thick of it, and that's what any team has to hope for, Chris, is keep it close with May Walsh and hope for a trickler and a dig at the end.
8-7 May Walsh, Jordan. And May with the stuff. Oh, Misty May. Looks like she knows what she's doing. Her third block.
Great blocking form by May here, reaching across the net. It looked as though they doubled up where Misty May was taking the line and Walsh was digging the line. A lot of cross court open. Jordan has to mix that cut shot, that soft angle shot in once in a while to keep Walsh honest on defense.
Third and final game, May and Walsh with a 2-point lead now, their biggest. Jordan comes to the right. And Kerry is right on it. Kerry Walsh, goodbye.
And yet another line shot and another lean toward the line shot by Walsh. She's picking everything up. Could be time for a timeout here. When a player doesn't even have to dive to get that ball, you know she was expecting that, running over in anticipation. Jordan and Davis have to mix in some cross-court hits.
A 9-3 scoring run for May and Walsh. Well, Misty May and Kerry Walsh upping the ante. And they look like the team to beat now. 10-7 they lead. Okay, fans, you can grab your cell phones right now and vote. Who do you think will record the most digs in 2006? If you want to text AVP A for Holly McPeak, AVP B for Rachel Walkholder, C for Nancy Mason, or D for Misty May. You can do that. Log on to AVP.com for results. Let's go down to Mike Dodd, standing by with Kerry Walsh. Mike.
Thank you, Chris. Kerry, a rough start in the first game. You guys have really managed to turn things around. What was the key?
Thankfully. I think just defense. You know, Misty, they were making great plays on Misty's siding out. You know, she was hammering it, but they were digging it, putting it away. But defense turned it around, and we need to keep winning this tournament with defense. It feels so good to play defense.
Loving to play defense. Chris Karchi, back up to you guys.
Kerry Walsh
with 62 open wins. She's fourth all time. Misty May, 66 open wins. She can tie the great Carolyn Kirby. Carolyn Kirby, who's that? Well, she and Liz Masakayan had the greatest record in the finals of any team in beach volleyball history. They were 26-1. They won 96% of their matches.
But if you ask Holly McPeak, she'd say, you've got to put an asterisk on that. Many of the players were split, and there were two tours going on at the same time. Not nearly the depth that there is on the AVP tour in recent years.
Hey, you know how to ruin a good story, Karch.
Well, it's an incredible percentage,
yep.
But they weren't facing all the best teams.
Wera Cry and Steffes, 80%, 74-18. That's pretty darn good. May Walsh, 60-13. So Gary Walsh over the top. Walsh and May with their 11th point.
And Walsh doing what Jordan and Davis need to do more of, and that is to hit the high, soft angle shot when the opposing defender is waiting down the line.
Davis and Jordan have given it everything they've got. They trail 11-8 in a game to 15. Do they have one more burst here? Jordan. And she smacks it home. So Jenny Johnson, Jordan, and Annette Davis will go to the perceived good side.
There is a little more wind now. They may be feeling it a little at the bottom of this beautiful tennis stadium here in Mason, Ohio. But good adjustment by Jordan on that play. Defense dropped off, no block. Once there's no block, you got to hammer away, and she found the corner.
Jordan has 20 kills. Now she sets to serve. Down by two, 11-9. Misty, Jordan is there. Big play, Jordan. Little off speed. Walsh has got it back.
Well, Chris, there was an opportunity at 4-1. They frittered it away, and then another opportunity to pull within 10-11 on that last play, but didn't get the set close enough. Right here. The set's far too much to Jordan's left shoulder. She didn't get a good swing on it. You have to put away that first ball on May and Walsh. Very rarely will you get another opportunity, another dig later in the rally.
Davis and Jordan, the fifth-seeded team, up against the number one-seeded team, and Davis going on two. So now a big stage in game three is Annette Davis, who is one of the top servers on the AVP2. She's got the wind in her face. Can she get some points on the good side? Where is the trickler, the ball that hits the top of the tape and dribbles over when you need it? 12-10, May Walsh. Misty's got it. Jordan, nice play. Davis. Oh, and Walsh stretching out her 6'3" frame with the block. 13-10.
13-10, and the 3 points frittered away. 3 traditional point opportunities now wasted by Jordan Davis. Got to put the hammer down on May and Walsh. That was just a little close. Even if Walsh hadn't blocked that ball, May was all over it. Needed the cut shot instead.
Both May and Walsh with 3 blocks, 6 total. 2 points away now as Jordan hits it out. 14-10 in game 3. Misty and Carey. Now we'll have championship point. Misty May will serve it. This could be it. Jordan to try to save it here. And Carey Walsh touched the net. So 1 championship point averted by Davis and Jordan.
But now they have the tougher type to avert, and that is when they are serving. The receiving team always has the advantage in volleyball just because the ball is in their hands. May and Walsh will have 3 such opportunities to close this out.
Jenny Jordan will serve it at 14-11. It's the second championship point for May Walsh. Misty for the win. Not yet. Oh, and Davis pokes it over Carey Walsh for a point. What a play by Annette Davis. Oh,
off her hands up high, Pokorama.
Well, when they use all three contacts, they haven't been able to turn some of those points. So Davis thinks, well, I'm just going to put it over on the second one when they're not ready. That will convert a point.
14-12 now. Davis and Jordan are behind. May and Wall still have their third chance at championship point. Misty with a swing. And she's got it. Misty May.